Isopropyl alcohol is a chemical compound found in antiseptics and other common household products, like lotions and cosmetics. It is also used in the synthesis of sarin, a deadly nerve agent banned by the Chemical Weapons Convention. How is this possible? What is a dual-use chemical? Put simply, a dual-use chemical is a chemical that can be used for both legitimate, peaceful purposes and harmful purposes. The world is full of them. We use them for everyday purposes in our homes, hospitals, cars, and schools. They are in the products we use to paint walls, write letters, and clean our hair. But some of these same chemicals can also be used to make chemical weapons, often with deadly consequences. For example, chlorine is a chemical used extensively in everyday life. It makes our drinking water safe, keeps swimming pools clean, and is used in the manufacturing of hundreds of products, including paper, paint, and textiles. But chlorine has also been used as a choking agent in chemical warfare. Heavier than air, when inhaled, chlorine is a poison gas that causes fluid to build up in the lungs, slowly suffocating its victims. Triethanolamine is another common chemical used in the manufacture of products such as sunscreen, dishwashing liquids, hand sanitizers, shaving cream, moisturizer, shampoo, and makeup remover. But it is also a precursor to mustard gas, a toxic blister agent that caused the blindness, disfigurement, and death of thousands of soldiers during World War I. Phosgene is a chemical used widely in plastics and is also used to manufacture polyurethane, a flexible foam used in furniture and mattresses. But in World War I, phosgene gas was used as a choking agent and was responsible for most of the war's chemical-related deaths. Like many chemical warfare agents, it works indiscriminately, affecting soldiers and civilians alike. So how can we live safely with dual-use chemicals? This is where the Chemical Weapons Convention comes in. The Chemical Weapons Convention is an international treaty dedicated to a world free of chemical weapons. 193 countries have signed and ratified the convention. They are working together as member states of the Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons, the OPCW, to implement it. The Chemical Weapons Convention bans the development, production, stockpiling, transfer, and use of chemical weapons. However, it also recognizes the dual-use nature of many chemicals and their importance in industry and development. Dual-use chemicals are allowed for purposes not prohibited by the convention, such as for industrial, agricultural, research, medical, pharmaceutical, protective, or other peaceful purposes. Many of these toxic chemicals are monitored under the watchful eye of the convention's verification regime. The OPCW and its member states work together at global, regional, and national levels to strengthen chemical safety and security practices. This lowers the risk of dual-use chemicals being diverted and developed into chemical weapons. Dual-use chemicals are part of our world. The Chemical Weapons Convention works to ensure that they are only used to benefit humanity. Learn more at opcw.org.